secret stuff. As soon as I can, find the scoop. Two scoops of pump product and half scoop of pre-workout. Oh, this is really, really bubbly.
The low top tubulars, they cut off the cage on them, right? And then they like basically look like sneakers, but like I would say like they're kind of like Yeezy look, or like this thing.
Oh, okay, I know what you mean. Yeah. Yes, I know what you mean.
They're fresh though, man. I liked them.
Pre-workout. What do you guys think? What do you think, bro?
What is good? Back in the gym with my boy Anderson, and today we're gonna hit a push workout. So first I'm actually gonna start off with some incline dumbbell press. Now typically every single workout that I have, you know, permitting on time and everything like that, I always have one compound movement that I really, really like to focus on, and today is going to be, for my push workout, is incline dumbbell press. So I typically do about 4 to 5 working sets. I'll work my way up to that specific working set, and today my rep scheme will be 4 to 6 reps. So I'll warm up again to my working weight, not caring about, you know, how many reps or sets I do for my warm up, but until I get to my working set. So let's get started. Okay, second warm-up set here, and I want to stress a little bit about this. Now, when you warm up, I want to stress that, you know, it doesn't matter how much weight you use. Honestly, it doesn't matter. It's a warm-up for a reason. You move up and you do a lot of preventative work from, obviously, so you don't get injured. But I treat my warm-up sets exactly how I treat my working sets in terms of form. So the form that I want to use on my working sets, I register that in my head with my warm-up weight. So I got 30 pounds here for the second warm-up set. Let's go. Last warm-up set just finished. I got 80s here, and I gauge it by kind of, I did 6 reps here, so it's getting kind of difficult, and I'm working to an exertion scale to where I don't fail. It's about an 80 to 85% working exertion scale, so these are good. I'm gonna move on to 90s for my first set and do 4 sets of 4 to 6 reps of that. Put these back, always put back your weights.
Never leave me, say. Never leave me, say. Never leave me, say.
I'm indestructible. Gangsta number one. Playing out Kralida.
Daughter, they come.
Daughter, they fall. You can't stop me. You can try, but you won't survive. Cause I'm a motherfucking ninja.
Zephside represent. You fucking with the best.
Second exercise here, did four sets on the incline dumbbell press, and we're moving on to this free motion chest press. Now I've improvised just a little bit. My back is off the pad, so I'm using my butt for the leverage, and I'm pressing forward, treating it as opposed to a fly movement, what this machine's made for. I'm improvising. I'm treating it as a pressing movement. So essentially, I'm mimicking the first movement, but in a cable form. So be creative. Be versatile in all your movements. Learn your movements, learn your environment, adapt to it, and mind muscle connection. So let's get started.
Ninja! You fuck up! Yeah, looks like I'm gonna need my. That black lock, I'm gonna need her. Every day's like bulletproof vest time. When you're rolling through the motherfucking Zep side. We don't stop at the road bus. In the day looking out 360 degrees. If you bust in the motherfucking donut, I'm not even thrusting a roadblock. Got pigs, plus caps in the back of your head. Bang, are you dead? What you gonna do, huh? Maybe go run Del Zuma. He doesn't give a fuck. That's why we keep a motherfucking gangster. I'm not scared of you, but you motherfucking scared of me. Yeah, the ninja has become the enemy.
Good? Alright. Alright guys, third exercise here is hammer strength incline chest press. So first was incline dumbbells, second was free motion cable press. We got another pressing movement here, and there's no weight. So let's put on some weight.
I'm indestructible. Gangsta number one. Playing out Kralida.
Daughter, they come.
Daughter, they fall. You can't stop me. You can try, but you won't survive. Cause I'm a motherfucking ninja.
If you don't lock funerals.
Typically with this,
you see a lot of different variations. Everyone plays a different role with their shoulders. So for me, that the way I target my medial head, which is the middle head, the best with lateral raises, is I kind of bring it up here, and if you see, my elbow is actually higher than my hands a little, just a tad bit, and I kind of arch it just a tad bit. So for me, that works the best. So in motion, I'm here, and my hands are a little bit lower. Sample on one of my push workouts. So I train 6 days a week, obviously. Push, leg, or back, pull, back, sorry guys. Pull, push legs, pull, push legs. So that's 6 days and one day off. I hope this gave you a little insight on how I train my chest, and maybe you could take a little bit away from that. You can obviously tweak it however you would like, sets, reps, etc. Add exercises, take out exercises depending on your needs. And that's pretty much it, guys. So hope you all enjoyed that. Thanks for watching.